Now look, I know, having an office is a lot of responsibility, okay? What we have to realize is that we're a family here at BSU Late Night, you know? Which brings me to my next topic, okay? No one should be tampering with the clocks, okay? This is a major thing. If you think it's daylight savings time, it may not be daylight savings time, Rico. So that doesn't mean you bring in a screwdriver and unscrew all the different damn clocks and set them back. Then we miss the show, okay? All right? Let's keep moving on. Let's move on. I just about 15 to 20 more points, we'll be out of here. The air duct system does work well in here. But if we finish our lunch, I ask you to please put it in the trash can and do not hide it in the vents.
She was budging in her chair a little too much for me not to notice. Plus, I think it might have been a queef.
Queef? I'm a lady.
I mean, it's just kind of like, you know, it's kind of like a sitcom family.
Oh my god. Oh my god, it smelled so bad. It wasn't me, I swear.
I'll smile no matter what whenever I hear or smell a fart.
No! What?
Oh god! Right from the bottom!
Yeah, it was me. I farted. We were in there for 3 hours and we were talking about nothing. Because ever since the third grade, I could fart on command.
Travel up!
No!
Oh, no!
Oh, God!
I can also queef on command.
That he wasn't actually turning the door handle, he was just kind of pounding on it.
Welcome to BSU Late Night, episode 13.
Yeah! Woo! Friday right. The 13th.
No.
Do what?
It's definitely not a Friday.
Come on!
All right. Friday the 13th.
Yeah!
What? All right. We have a great show for you, but we're just going to get into things. Right. There's a new law in Malawi.
What the hell is a Malawi?
Irrelevant, Brian. Oh. New law in Malawi has criminalized farting in public. They have a no flatulence zone. That's horrible. The justice minister stated on local radio, just go to the toilet when you feel like farting.
Wait, go to the toilet to actually fart?
Yeah.
You know, what's next? No pocket pool on the bus?
Brian, it's inappropriate. Stop. Hands out of the pockets.
Why?
No, hands out of the pockets.
Okay.
Okay. Two West Virginia cousins were pulled over and arrested this week because they had a car full of stolen Slim Jims. They planned to resell the jerky and travel to New Staten to help out their relatives with car troubles. I'm sorry, what is our world coming to? How do you get to that point in your life where you feel it's a great idea to steal a shit ton of beef jerky in hopes of selling it so you have enough funds to finance a trip across state to help your relatives with car trouble. Wow.
You know, that story, it hits so close to home, Shane. I mean...
Really?
That's interesting. Yeah. We'll just move on. In Albuquerque, New Mexico, a $50,000 giant cactus was reported stolen from a local park. Let's take a look at that.
Yeah.
Now, the cactus was later found in a landfill, but was too damaged to re-erect in the park.
And there are many suspects for this case, but only one that has the ability of stealing a giant fiberglass cactus. Take a look.
I mean...
It's the only guy that they have out there. Yep, it's him.
Oh.
It's gotta be him. Good old big boy.
I tell you what. Now
oh
in,
my God.
Now in California, a robber busted into an Italian pizza joint, and you know, with a gun and pepper spray, of all things. And he was demanding money, folks. And when he asked about the incident, you know, the pizza shop owner said,
"First of all, you're gonna come into my pizza joint and try and rob a couple of eye ties? No siree, Bob. Okay, so what we did was we jumped the counter and put the damn buffoon ghoul in a schoolyard headlock and just busted his head on the cash register. You want money? Go get a job." So we had a last pizza in a pizza oven, and I says, "Hey, Tony, you and Donnie deliver that pizza, and I'll take care of this hoodlum." So I guts this fool still in a headlock, and he tries to get away. So I give him the old suplex, dropped him right on his back. Kid had something coming to him. I pin him on the ground until the cops get there, and the rest is history.
Hey, oh, that was good. I like that. We practiced that quite a bit, you know. Shane, what happened to your voice? That was...
Forget about it!
All right. Forgetting, folks.
Okay.
You know, it's Oscar season. And
oh, yes.
So in honor of the Oscars, our top 10 list for this week is the top 10 movies that deserve an Oscar.
Deserve an Oscar.
Let's get right into it. Ladies and gentlemen, number 10.
Gladiator. How was it overlooked that Joaquin Phoenix played a sane person for the entire film?
Oscar-worthy. Number 9.
Dr. Doolittle. Anyone else freaked out about the obsessive amount of real talking animals?
Oscar! Number 8.
The Last Airbender. Oscar twist Shyamalan style.
Ooh, number 7.
Furry Vengeance.
Oscar-worthy.
Wasn't that a porno?
Nah, well, number 6.
Okay, The Dilemma. Did Kevin James put on weight? Now that's Oscar dedication.
It really is. Number 5.
Sex in the City 2. Four elderly women in a desert. I smell
Oscar bait. Number 4.
The Mummy 3. They took what we loved in the first one and put it in China.
Two Oscars, damn it! Number 3.
Good Burger. Who knows what's in the secret sauce? I don't, but it's
Oscar-worthy! Number 2.
Never Say Never. Because gay is okay.
Oscar. And ladies and gentlemen, the number 1 movie that deserves an Oscar.
Big Mama's House 3. Hear me out. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Fool me 3 times,
Oscar!
All right, folks, we have a great show for you today. SGA Hopeful's Campus Voice are in the house. And when we come back, we are going to have this place cooking.
Stay tuned.
Stay tuned.
Yeah, you know, accessing with no arms, it's a pretty daunting task, but, you know, I gotta do what I gotta do. And, those days when I need an extra boost, I know exactly what I should do for adaptability.
Embryos.
First, you open up the box. 2, you dispense the contents. 3, you eat them. And fourth of all, you let them grow. Embryos. A bit of growth in every bite. Post-operating companies.
Embryos, my bit of growth.
Welcome back to BSU
Late Night.
Later on in the show, we have Campus Voice, so stay tuned for that. But for right now, we have a French cook. So take it away.
Hello, my name is Guillaume Fabien Paul Blanc. Impatiently, you must forgive my English. It's not the best. Fortunately, we here at Bow State Late Night have a very gifted translator intern.
Oh, no,
His name is Donny Schitz.
It's Schultz. It's Schultz. We went over this twice before. Just go ahead and I'll...
Okay, oui, Donny. Okay. Are you ready for ice?
Yeah, I guess.
All right, let's go, Pussy Mouse.
Okay.
Pour vous, les habitants de Mancy, je vais commencer avec quelque chose familier. Greek's Pizzeria. Dans ce restaurant familial, il y a beaucoup de styles de pizza et de tailles différentes à Greek's Pizza.
I know, I missed a lot of that. He went so fast. It was, you know, he said something about Greeks, and I think he's French, so he's probably still upset from one of the wars, because he said something about the mouth. Yeah, no, I got it.
Ouais, très bien, d'accord. Avec les ingrédients et les saveurs fantastiques, vous allez revenir chez nous très vite après chaque morceau.
Something's fantastic about the Greeks. I think it's their ability to fight. He was really talking about, he's going really, I just took a semester here. I'm not a real translator. The guy didn't show up and they pulled me out of the hall.
D'accord, très bien. Le deuxième restaurant, c'est Puerta Vallarta. Si te gusta la comida mexicana, creo que este restaurante es para ti. Son mexicanos que cocinan los platos con esta comida. Les vas a echar un pedo y de esta manera podrás saberlo que es la verdadera comida mexicana.
Now he switched dialects there. I think he just spoke Spanish because he said in Spanish that the Alamo is a thing to be remembered. And that the food is very, I don't know. Oh God, I'm missing it. I'm messing up.
Monsieur Sheets.
D'accord.
Fusion wa atarashi no restauranto desu ne. Son restauranto wa o sushi to hibachi ga arimasu. Kono restauranto wa sugoi to oishi desu yo.
He's switching dialects on me. Maybe Mandarin that time? I'm really trying to keep up here. You know, can you slow down a bit?
Oui.
Great, thank you.
Yes, for you? Yeah. Très bien, merci. Finalement, le meilleur endroit qui représente mes origines et que je peux retrouver ici à Mancy, c'est le bistrot de Veramaille. Mon plat préféré, c'est les escargots pour le petit déjeuner.
I'm dropping the ball on this. I'm sorry. I really don't know what else to say. He's obviously not understanding me.
Merci beaucoup. C'est fini. Et maintenant, choisissez votre restaurant préféré.
Please don't fire me. Enjoy the meal.
Merci. Oh.
Oh, wow. That's unusual.
Did you catch that?
Oui, oui.
Oui. Mon Dieu. Thank you, guys. Thanks for coming on.
Yeah,
when we come back, we have Campus Voice here in the house, and we will do an interview with them. And don't tell them, but we're going to debate them a little later.
Hope it goes well.
We'll be back right after this.